Hey everybody, Daniel Hayes here, bringing you what I hope will be another Hayski adventure. Right now, we're heading for the Cape. In my 45 plus year teaching career, I always had to travel during the high season. I always had to travel when everybody else was traveling. And I always had it in the back of my head that when I retired, I would be able to go places when everybody else was leaving there. And for the last couple of years, I've had the opportunity to go to Cape Cod on Labor Day when everyone else was leaving. I always pictured myself sailing into Cape Cod effortlessly when the traffic jam was coming out the other way. So that's what I'm doing again this year, and I'm glad to bring you along with me. Thanks for being here, and we'll investigate the Cape and at the beginning of the off season. So we'll start our Cape adventure in Hyannis, which is pretty centrally located on the Cape. And then the plan is to head for Martha's Vineyard for a day. And then after that, to head up to P-Town, Provincetown, which I haven't been to in years. So I hope you'll stick around and join us, and maybe even be kind enough to hit the like and subscribe buttons below. Here's the room, straight out through to the balcony, overlooking the pool. So it's a pretty nice location, right in the center of Hyannis, close to the beaches and ferries, and nice place to stay. So I thought I'd take you on a little walk down Main Street. Hyannis. So it's late afternoon, early evening, and the main street is just coming to life, just a little bit. Of course, it's after Labor Day, so things are died down, but it's still got a nice little bustle to it. Antoine. Town hall down that way. There's a pretty little park and art exhibits down that way as well.
Hey, goofy camera guy.
post office to the left, and then the JFK Museum ahead. Out of the Main Street area. And some pictures of vintage Hyannis. Public library. Notice my strength in not stopping in to see if they have my books. Oh, and plus they're closed. A lot of candy and ice cream in Hyannis. Always a sign of a good place. Baptist Church across the street. losing light quickly behind the buildings. I guess it's more evening than afternoon, like I said earlier. But it's a beautiful night. The air is just soft and sweet. I always love a good Indian restaurant. I'll have to check that one out sometime. The Egg and I. An ode to my chickens. Columbos. Smith family popcorn. Oh, instant karma. New age gift shop. Hippie boutique. I think they're closed, but I'll have to check that out sometime. Soft as a grape. More ice cream. The head stash. I bet I know what's in there. Tibetan mandala. The grilled cheese gallery. I'm assuming that's not paintings of grilled cheese. Navy surplus. Mexican bistro we just passed. residence at 615 Main Street. Be fun to live up there. So I think we're coming to the end of the old part of Main Street, and it continues on with motels and 7-Elevens and things like that. A little more modern commercial. Let's see if I have time to take you down to the beachfront before it gets too dark. It's getting a little dark, but we'll cut through here. See if we can make it to the waterfront before it's completely dark. It's pretty with all the different colors on the top floor of Town Hall. The pattern on the walkway has a definite weave to it. If you'd had a bit too much to drink, it would just be perfect. So these buildings are celebrating artists in Hyannis. Different displays they have throughout the year. Cross there without getting hit. rabbit in there saying hello. Hey guy. Losing light fast, but I think you'll be able to see this. Wish you could experience this soft night air. It's our weavy path again. The High Line, high speed ferry. Back on Ocean in Maine, and I'm looking into the window of what seems to be a bridal shop, but it's downright ghostly. I don't know if you can see it. Some of them are missing their arms. Some slow children around here. And right ahead is the Kennedy compound. I know they'd never forgive me if I didn't stop. Thinking none of the Kennedys were home, because even though I hung out there for a while and they had to have seen me, nobody came out. Coming up on the right is St. Francis Xavier Church, where the Kennedys attended Mass.